Okay, in this video we're going to do a couple of limits that involve factoring to find the answer. So let's get started. The first example that we're going to do is the limit as x approaches 5 of x squared minus 25 over x minus 5. So if you've done any limits, you've probably seen a limit like this one before. The first thing you always want to try to do when you're evaluating limit is just substitute straight in. So I want to try to sub in 5, see if I get an answer. So I do that and I get 0 over 0, which is not an acceptable answer. That's actually an indeterminate form. There's a couple things you can do. The first thing, and obviously in this video, we're talking about factoring. So I'm going to try to factor and see if what I get cancels down. So this will be equal to the limit as x approaches 5 of factoring the numerator into x plus 5, x minus 5. So difference of squares is a big deal here. And then you can actually see I can cancel. So I have x minus 5 over x minus 5. I'm going to cancel those, which means I'm really getting an equivalent limit here. The limit as x approaches 5 of the quantity x plus 5. And that's obviously just going to be 10. So the answer to this limit question is 10. Depending on what you're doing with limits, if you were to graph x squared minus 25 over x minus 5, that function actually has a removable discontinuity at x equals 5, and the value of, if there had been a point there, it would be 10. It kind of fills in the hole in the graph. But we're just doing limits, so let's take a look at another one. So this one is going to be the limit as x approaches 3 of x cubed minus 27 over x minus 3. So again, I'm going to try to substitute in, see if it works. I get 0 over 0, which is indeterminate, so I'm going to do some more work. If you look at x cubed minus 27, that's a difference of cubes, right? It's x cubed minus 3 cubed. I personally can never remember how to factor a difference of cubes. So what I do instead is, if you think about this, we know that plugging 3 in gives us 0 in x cubed minus 27. So that means that x minus 3 must be a factor of x cubed minus 27, and that gives me enough information to actually factor this thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide. I'm going to do synthetic division. So 3, and then you got to account for everything. So it's there's 1x cubed, 0x squared, there's 0 x's, and then minus 27. Then you do the drop down, multiply, drop down, multiply, drop down, multiply, and we get this. So that means that we can actually factor it. So I'm going to rewrite my limit as x approaches 3 as x minus 3 and then the quantity x squared plus 3x plus 9 and then over the original x minus 3. Now I can cancel that x minus 3. I'm going to rewrite an equivalent limit, which gives me this. Now I'm going to substitute in, so I get 9 plus 9 plus 9, and that equals 27, which is the answer to this limit question. Let's take a look at another one. So far we've seen difference of squares, difference of cubes. Here we have the limit as x approaches 4, radical x minus 2 over x minus 4. There isn't really an obvious difference of anything in here, although those are the most common thing. Other than just straight up factoring, those are the most common things we deal with. So let me try to sub in. I get 0 over 0. But if you look a little more closely at that denominator, it's not so normal to treat it this way. But x minus 4 could be viewed as a squared minus b squared. If you view it that way, then a is going to be the square root of x, and b is going to be 2. And now we can use a difference of squares, so that's obviously what I'm going to try. So let's see. So I get the limit as x approaches 4. So the numerator is the same. Now I'm factoring the denominator into this weird difference of squares. I think the reason you don't see that a lot is because you don't get rational exponents. And like when you learn difference of squares, you probably haven't learned about rational exponents yet. So I don't know why you don't see that until roughly here in your math education. And now we can cancel, which gives us an equivalent limit of this. And now we can substitute in. We get our answer. There you go, 1/4. So we're going to look at one more, which I like to give as a problem often. And it's weird because it kind of like messes with, you know, what you know about difference of squares, difference of cubes. Kind of gets right down to, do you understand? So direct substitution in this case, I'm going to plug in 4. I'm going to do the square root of 4 is 2, cube it and get 8. So I have 8 minus 8, that's 0. The denominator is pretty clearly 0. So what I'm going to do is, if you look at that numerator, you have x to the 3/2 minus 8. 8 is definitely a cube. X to the 3/2 is also a cube. It's just that it's x to the 1/2 cubed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let u equal the square root of x. And that would allow me to rewrite the thing I'm taking the limit of as u cubed minus 8 over u squared minus 4. I just factored a difference of cubes, so I actually remember it this time, over u minus 2, u plus 2. Then I can cancel that. And so this is equivalent to the thing that I'm taking the limit of. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to change my limit into the limit of that thing, where I'm going to replace all of the u's with the square root of x. So square root of x squared is just x, and then plus 2 radical x plus 4 over radical x plus 2. And now I'm going to substitute in, and I get 4 plus 4 plus 4 over 2 plus 2, which is 3, and that's the value of the limit. Okay, so that's a couple of examples of how you can use factoring to evaluate limits. You always want to first check and just try to plug in, and hopefully you get a number as your answer there, and then you're done. But if you don't, if you get 0 over 0, then what you might want to try to do is factor and see if it helps. Anyway, hope you found this helpful, and good luck.